Oh my gosh. I know. And okay. This is a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes, right? Aren't I?
Right. You're fine.
Okay, there's people coming in though. I just don't know.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes.
And you'll take your mask off.
Yeah. Okay. And then.
Read all of it.
Okay, I'm not going to read it all now because.
Right.
And then at the end, I'm going to go, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Just a little bit of silence. And then you come back down. And the reading should be up here, but you bow. And then back to your feet. You have second reading in the New Testament. So then those are the psalm.
Now, when I start this,
do I just start?
A reading from the second letter, and you're proclaiming it. So you want to go, I told your mom and I told your uncle, especially since it's live stream, you want to be strong.
Okay.
You want to be slow. Don't rush through it like this, because then they won't be able to understand what you know, and they're not here.
Right.
I mean, it's true of the people in the pews, too.
Right.
Nice and slow. Nice and strong, okay? And so that we can keep up with you.
Okay.
So go ahead.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul.
Okay. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians.
Most excellent.
Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly, and then I go through it, right?
Right. So just keep your voice up all the time.
Okay.
And speak, this is your...
And I can take this off when I'm reading. Yeah.
Everybody takes their mask off when they read, right? Until you get to the end.
Uh-huh.
Then you say, the word of the Lord.
The word of the Lord.
We say, thanks be to God. Same thing, bow your head, just a little bit of silence afterwards.
So you guys say thanks.
We say thanks be to God, right?
Okay.
And then you come back, you just reverse it.
Okay.
You come back.
Thank you.
you're going to come here to the ambo. And then you speak into the microphone because it's live stream. You want to be nice and slow, nice and strong.
Okay.
And I can bring you down if I need to.
Okay.
But, you know, so...
Okay.
So he'll say a little bit at the beginning, like we place our petitions before our Lord, right? And then say maybe just the first one.
Okay. For Patricia, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life.
Okay. Can you be stronger?
Yeah.
You won't wear your mask.
Okay.
Right. So for the, like when you're up here, you'll take your mask off before.
Okay.
So try it one more time.
Okay. For Patricia, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life.
Be nice and slow because people at home, even people in the pews can't keep up if you go fast.
Okay.
Slow, clear, right? When I do it, I like to say, for Patricia,
and then
a pause, and then say what you're praying for.
Okay.
The second one, for our sister who ate the bread of the body of Christ. Comment is a nice pause, and then tell us what you're praying for.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, perfect. They should be. Do you want to use this?
Well, they have another one here.
Right. So, which do you like using? Because when I put it in the book, my father and I, it'll be this. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. So there you can have that in your pew. And then we'll just show you the book when you have it.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Norbert Parish Community and to our massive Christian burial. Please stand as we begin our worship.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Patricia died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Please be seated.
Good morning. My sister Tricia and I want to thank all of you who came and those that are watching online to help to honor our mom, Pat McFadden. Our mom touched a lot of lives. Some of them are here, some aren't, but there were so many. She was the most special woman we ever knew, and we feel so grateful that she was our mom. If we were to define the perfect mom, it would be Pat. She encouraged us, she coached us, she taught us, built us up, bandaged and kissed our boo-boos, and never missed a beat. She loved her kids and her grandkids unconditionally, and she expected very little in return. When we were young, our mom raised 5 kids, born in cities all across the United States. And then it made it her passion to give us a good Catholic education, brought us through all the sacraments, and to love Jesus Christ. She ran us all over town to keep us busy and learning new things, volunteered her time and talents at church and school, and never left any one of us waiting too long for a ride or help if we needed it. Our mom made sure we all got where we were going, and then she usually squeezed in time to volunteer or lead one or more activities as well. She ran a tennis club. She was a community response volunteer. She coached a girls' Catholic Youth Organization, CYO basketball team for many years, and even got them into the national championship once in St. Joseph's, Missouri. When we were old enough, she helped each of us get jobs and learn responsibility. And then she'd drive us there if we were running late. After our mom raised us, she went into teaching. As a teacher, she helped many students to begin to love school and learning. In all of the schools that she worked, from Devereaux, locally here, to the inner city schools in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, and also in Florida, she always volunteered to work with the children who needed a little extra special care and more time to learn. In her things, we found many dozens of letters, notes, commendations, plaques and awards from school administrators, and handwritten letters from the parents of her students. Children who, in many cases, for the first time, loved their school experience largely because, and looked forward to going back to school each day, largely because of Miss Pat. On some occasions, Pat would bring children home with her after school in case they had nowhere else to go before dinner. That's just the way she was. Pat was a good Christian neighbor for her entire life. Wherever she lived, from places like California to New Jersey, from Pennsylvania to Boca Raton, Florida, in her later years, she always went out of her way to greet and welcome the new neighbors. She was inviting, inclusive, patient, and cheerful. A longtime neighbor on her Boca Raton street approached me recently after Pat was gone. He wanted me to know that Pat was the first one on the street to welcome him and his family when they moved in 30 plus years ago, and that our mom was always generous and helpful to their family. As Mum, and we also called her Mumsy, Pat showered her grandchildren with love and attention. She made sure that the extended family got together every Christmas time on Christmas Eve, and she made sure that every kid felt special. All of the grandchildren had an unlimited invitation to Mumsy's home in Boca Raton, and even their friends were welcome to come, sometimes even 4 to 5 kids, staying an entire week at a time. She often did their laundry during their visit and usually made them a small photo album at the end of the trip. Pat had a wonderful life because she made it that way, but it wasn't without some sadness. She never imagined that God would call 3 of us kids before her. Our siblings, John, James, Barbara, and Sheila. It's so difficult to imagine a mom losing a child. But our mom lost 3 over the years. Today, she has gone to join them in heaven. There's a song that I heard recently that I'd like to quote the chorus. The song is by Ed Sheeran, and the song is called Supermarket Flowers. The chorus goes like this. Oh, I'm in pieces. It's tearing me up now, but I know. A heart that's broke is a heart that's been loved. So I'll sing hallelujah. You were an angel in the shape of my mom. When I fell down, you'd be there holding me up. Spread your wings as you go. And when God takes you back, he'll say, hallelujah, you're home.
Let us stand and pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Patricia, whom you have called to journey to you. And since she hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our true homeland, to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. Time to give birth and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot the plant. Time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. Time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. Time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. Time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. Time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. What profit have workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to mortals to be busied about. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into their hearts so they cannot find out from beginning to end the work which God has done. I recognize that there is nothing better than to rejoice and to do well during life. Moreover, all can eat and drink and enjoy the good of all their toil. This is a gift of God. I recognized that whatever God does will endure forever. There is no adding to it or taking from it. Thus has God done that he may be revered. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Overflows. The Lord is
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. We are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Come to me, all you that labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be." "Where I am going, you know the way," Thomas said to him. "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
The time there was a beloved queen who cared greatly for her people, and she wanted what was best for them. The people, in turn, respected her. And periodically, this queen would disguise herself, and she would wander around the streets of the kingdom, trying to see what life was like from the perspective of her people. So one day, disguised as a poor beggar, she went to visit the public baths. And many people were enjoying the fellowship and the relaxation in this place. She found out that the water for the baths was heated by a furnace in the basement, where one person was responsible for maintaining the proper temperature. So the queen made her way to the basement to visit this person, who tirelessly tended the fire. The two shared a meal together, and the queen befriended the lonely person. And day after day and week after week, the queen went to visit this person. And over time, the two became very good friends. So one day, the queen decided to reveal her true identity to her new friend. She knew it was risky because she feared that the person might ask for special favors or a gift. Instead, the queen's new friend looked into her eyes and said, "You left your comfortable palace to sit with me in this hot, dingy basement. You ate my meager food and genuinely showed you cared about what happened to me. On other people, you might give rich gifts, but you've given me the greatest gift of all, the gift of yourself. What greater gift can a person bestow on another than one's physical and mental presence? You know the old age expression that says 90% of life is simply showing up? What a great gift it is to be present at important times in one's life. I have to say to you, from what I've heard about Pat and knowing some of the things that Mike has shared with me, she had the qualities of that kind of a person. She was able to truly be present, to love, and to be a generous giver of herself. I have to say, losing someone we love is difficult. It can leave us feeling broken or even pulled apart. Perhaps you might feel abandoned or even forgotten by God. And so on behalf of the entire parish family, all of you who are here and all who are watching at home, I'd like to offer to you, Tricia and Michael, along with Joseph and Stephanie and Christina and Manny, along with Pat's great-grandchildren, our deepest heartfelt sympathy on the loss of your mom and your mom. I'm told that Pat, as a young girl, was happy and active, and she had fond memories of the errands that her father would send her on. She always loved being counted upon. Just that kind of sense of being able to give of herself. It seems to me that at the core of who Pat was, today we're invited to be grateful for the great gifts that Patricia bestowed on us in so many different ways. And the readings today describe, I think, how God works in our lives. So from Ecclesiastes, you get a sense that there's a time and a place for everything that God wants. And it's not like God punishes us, but God uses the stuff of our lives to bring us closer, to mold us and to shape us. And you get a sense that God was always a part of Pat's life, your lives, as that kind of stuff was unfolding, and God used it. And then in the gospel, we're reminded that God has prepared a place for her. I think it has to have a lot of different rooms for all of her grandchildren and great-grandchildren, a place where she can make people feel welcome and at home. Mike shared with me that no matter what any of the kids did, they always experienced their mom's unconditional love, and that she was the glue that held the family together. Imagine all the lives that she touched as a special ed teacher, as a coach, and just volunteering in so many different ways. We would be less than human if a great sadness didn't envelop us for our mom and for our mama, who was such a woman of faith and goodness, for one who gave of herself to others, and that God has taken her home. For Pat, we believe that she now enjoys the new heaven and a new earth that is the promise of a God that we all believe. Therefore, even in our sadness, we find just a little hope that she's reached the goal for which all humans are ultimately destined. We too hope that one day we will return home and be with her, and be with her children, and all the loved ones that she's lost. She will continue to live on in your hearts. And maybe that's the big house where she has gained her dwelling. And that living on in your hearts, may you always have the courage to follow her example. Because she was a courageous woman, it sounds like. So follow her lead. And bring the gift of yourselves to other people so that one day you too can also find a way home to eternal salvation with Jesus and with our sister in a new heaven, a new earth. So let me leave you just with one image. Jesus' outstretched arms, waiting to accept her and to hug her and to hold her. May your hearts too be enveloped in that same love.
I'd ask you to please stand with me and let us bring our needs before our loving and merciful God.
Okay. For Patricia, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends, and for our sister Patricia, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, and who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we ask you to hear all of these prayers and that you grant them according to your will. The prayers we make in the name of Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Sisters and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Patricia, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ the Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our sisters and brothers, especially today, Patricia, who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Norbert, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, through the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Stand. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For Catholics, we believe that this is the real presence, the very body and blood of Jesus. And we welcome you, if you share that belief, to come and receive Jesus in communion. To do that in these abnormal times, I'd ask you to come out, form a single line, and when the minister says to you, the body of Christ, you would extend your hand and say amen. The minister will place it on your hand. If you turn and lift your mask just over your mouth and consume the body of Christ, and then go back to your seat, it seems to be the safest way to help with the spread of COVID. Let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Patricia may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Maria.
Please stand. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Pat in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Step by take, let this be.